Our bodies are genetically different. Not all have the same mutated genes, but our brains are genetically different than typical people. When we encounter certain substances, we have adverse reactions and wind up in toxic bodies, medicines, foods, immunizations, environments, etc. Autism is a developmental condition in which a human responds or reacts differently than a neurotypical human. Autism is the way the brain processes. Basically, it describes our relationship and view to the world around us. Anxiety, depression, ADHD, PTSD, sensory issues, etc. All of those are conditions that we are more prone to develop due to the construct of our bodies. Not all autistic people stim. Not all autistic people have language delays. Not all autistic people have meltdowns. Not all autistic people are introvert. Not all autistic people see acting neurotypical as goal. The only true definition of autism is one that describes a being's perception and reaction to his or her environment. Unfortunately, people are taught disgusting narratives full of fear and talk, and neurotypical people often fall into arrogances by assuming that getting rid of a neurotypical minds in some way better. I am brain. I am my brain. I love myself. Neurotypical and neurodiverse people can have sensory issues, anxiety, and other issues. Some people who are deprived of oxygen have similar challenges as some autistic people. That doesn't mean that they are autistic. Autism is not comprised of only unique challenges. Autistic people have a unique perspectives, one of innocence, profound truths, and an awareness that goes behind need. We must change the narratives to see that next generation doesn't accept self-hate and misinformative of identity.
What can you do to find out why an autistic person has had a sudden mood change? Many caretakers, parents, and guardians are often worried when there is behavior or mood change of unknown origin. They often beat themselves up because they associate these occurrences with the idea that they are inadequate to help. Today, I hope you realize that it's not true. If you went to a foreign country, would you expect yourself to instantly learn the language and culture? No. Autism is as such. We perceive the world among neurotypical humans to be different, just as you observe an autistic person and need time to learn. We are symbiotic in this process of learning. Some problems are there that are being faced by an autistic person in this society. Many neurotypical people try to resolve an issue with an autistic person, as if the person thinks the same as them. We don't, no matter what level assigned to us. We are uniquely different than those born with a neurotypical brain function. Many caretakers mistakenly are taught that these meltdowns, sudden mood changes, etc., are done intentionally. Healthcare professionals and some ABA therapists have you address this as something that is to be resolved by withholding, disciplining, and a bunch of others' idiocy. Now, what is the solution? It's too listening to anyone that makes you feel like it's too hard to understand your child or autistic adult. Realize that your every behavior is an effort to communicate something. Be patient. You can be who you need to be and might learn some beautiful things from the world of autism. For children, create a quiet, magical place and sit it in with them. Many people don't realize that many of the reasons our behavior changes is due to fear. Doctors always tell people that we have meltdowns because we're overwhelmed, but it can be much more than that. I remember as a child feeling a sense of terror when my sensory issues were too much for me to handle alone. But the problem was that I didn't know how to express what I needed, nor did I understand the need. By creating a space such as a small indoor tent, a giant moving box, or a tent made out of blankets, etc., this allows me a space to go where not only is the noise and light less, but I also have a sense of control in a neurotypical dominated world. Then just sit and let the autistic person invite you into the wonder of how we view life. Don't ask questions expecting an answer. Ask questions to express that you desire to understand whatever they want to tell you. Sometimes you can learn more by simply observing than directing. Now, if we talk about the adults, for adults, some autistic adults will enjoy the previous solution, while sensory seekers and other adults differ. Find an activity that they enjoy that is conducive to engaging in an exchange of information. This can be as simple as enjoying an ice cream cone together. Give the autistic adult the floor, allowing them to speak or engage. You let them direct the flow. Even if it seems off topic, just listen and ask questions as they arise. One of the major things autistic adults hate is when people associate communication differences as if we are children instead of childlike. Don't treat us as a small children in regard to controlling us. What is this called? An infantilized person. That is a person who has been treated as a child, although their age and mental capacity is not that of a child. This treatment is infantilization. Behavior or mood change always has a reason. We are autistic. Our brains operate differentially. Often we cannot find the correct combination of the words to relay what's going on. There can be serious reasons and also things you deem simple as you don't notice. Make sure the child or adult feels safe. The second thing is ask if anything in their body hurts. As with any human, a biological reason can cause mood or behavior change. The third is track food consumption. Moods are influenced by it greatly. The fourth is consider if the autistic person had something changed their routine. Evaluate the people they come in control with. Check for signs of abuse or neglect. This will often look different than a neurotypical person. Remember that though different brain, we are all one species. Stop feeling as if we are so foreign to you that are inadequate to properly raise, assist, or support us. All autistic humans, no matter chronologically age, autistic people always have a key that you find for entrance. Music, it can be art, it can be movies, an outdoor activity, etc., etc. There is something that allows me to connect to you. Now, what should you do to stop? Stop worrying. The best parent, guardian, or caretaker is not perfect. Autistic people are not truly a conundrum when you have yourselves to experience moments with you. Not be in a place where we are coerced, intimated, or bullied into trying to merge over two selves.